In today's episode, I'm going to show you how to install mesh bed leveling on your Ender 3 V2, right here at Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. I've got two Ender 3 V2s, and this one just never seems to level right for me, so I want to install mesh bed leveling. To install mesh bed leveling, you have to update your firmware, and this firmware site has been recommended to me by numerous viewers. I'll put a link to it in the description below. I see why this is recommended. There's a lot here, including default files for the 422 and 427 board. There's a lot of different BLTouch versions that you can download. There's also the universal bed level, which is relatively new. I'm still learning this. And there's source code included, which is really nice. But in this video, I'm going to install the 5x5 manual mesh. I'm going to install this on my Ender 3 V2, which has a 32-bit version 4.2.2 board. To install this, download their .bin file onto a blank 8GB SD card. Then just turn power off to your machine, insert the SD card into the SD card slot, and then turn on power. And the machine will reboot, you'll get a blank screen, and then the Creality screen will come up. And you should notice that the info box is replaced by the new level menu. Info is now moved to the control menu all the way at the bottom. You click on that and you can verify that you've updated the firmware. To prepare the machine, I cleaned the bed with some soapy water and then wiped it off with a dry paper towel. And then I cleaned the nozzle to make sure there was no filament sticking out that would cause me bad readings. Under the new prepare menu, there's a manual leveling option, and this levels above the adjustment knobs, just like I normally do, and I showed in my previous bed leveling video. So I ran that just to get everything close. I ran each corner, but then when I got to the center, it was off. So this bed is slightly warped. I'm hoping mesh bed leveling will fix that. Now we go to the level menu, and this is the mesh bed leveling. First, it homes the machine, and then it'll go to that first point. So it homes it. And then it says it's going to go to the first point. And that's right in the corner, not above the knob, just in a corner. And this is 5x5. And then there's a micro step up and down. I'm going to use the micro step down. If you hold it, it'll go down from the starting position of point two. So all I did was rub the paper and hold down the knob until it started to grab. And then I clicked on next point. And I just repeated the same steps. I scrolled down to the micro step down. I held the button until the paper rubbed. And then I stopped and then clicked on next point. So basically I did this across the whole bed. There's 25 points because it's 5x5. So it got a reading at each point. When it was done, then I clicked on save mesh and it saves those values to the memory on the control board. To use those values at the start of a print, I'm going to change my start G code. So I'll go to manage printers within Cura, machine settings, and then after the G28 home, I put a M420 space S1. That loads the mesh bed level before the print starts. After I did that, I remembered that they offered the source code. So I downloaded the source code and went to the mesh level and found the configuration at H and proved that they had defined the restore level after G28. So after G28 home, it automatically restores the leveling. So I didn't have to use that M420 command. I don't think it hurts anything, but I didn't have to do it. And I loaded in my basic squares that I used to test bed leveling. And this will just, you know, go around only one level and then I'll stop it. And here's the results. This is one of the best test prints I've ever gotten. In a previous video, I showed a plugin for Cura that gives you a list of test prints. And one of them is a bed level calibration print. And it's a series of squares that are connected by lines, which are actually squares. So it starts out drawing these fine squares and then it forms these smaller squares, which get filled in. So I figured I'd run this test print. Now, as it was going down, I could see there was a few spots the filament wasn't sticking as well as I'd like. And it was on the outer edges, like here at the front, it was lifting back in the corner. It was not sticking real well. And there was a little bit of lifting here on this one pad. But other than that, it wasn't too bad, but certainly not perfect. But the center was better than I was getting before. It may not be perfect, but this mesh bed leveling definitely improved the results on this particular V2. Creality did send me one of their BLTouch auto-leveling kits, and it's on sale right now for $39.99. And then I'll try out this software for the BLTouch and see if that makes it even better. If you want to see that, let me know in the comments below.
If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.